Good day, mateys. Thanks for tubing in to Pirates in Teepees. Drone S500 quadcopter is fully assembled, and it is time to do the initial setup and configuration on the PX4 flight controller. So, I've got everything all hooked up, and I now have a USB connection to the computer. I have APM planner program opened up. I've selected my device's AMC0. We're going to go to initial setup. I'm going to click on APM quadcopter and hit OK on the firmware upgrade there. Boom, if it's already downloaded, it's doing its thing here. Now it's going to upload. You can see here it's downloading the firmware, and then it's going to upload it to the PX4 floor. Once that's done, then we will be able to go through and configure the next thing. So now it's flashing firmware. Oh, I had to unplug and plug it back in. So I'm following the thing. Now it's flashing the firmware here. It's still continuing that process. So once that's done and we're ready to go, we'll be able to move on to the next step. So this PX4 flashing is complete. Okay, boom, now we're good to go here. Next thing we wanna do is go to 3DR radio. We're gonna click on advanced settings, select the serial port, which is, for me, TTY USB 0. Boom, make sure the baud rate is set to 57600 and hit apply. Then you're going to be able to hit load settings here. It's going to enter command mode. Boom. And at this point, it's calibrated both things. Here we'll hit save settings. And then we're going to copy required items to remote. That's all done and good to go. And everything is success. We're going to move on to, okay, we're going to go back to the initial screen flight data. Then we're going to unplug the USB. Now we're going to plug this thing in. So we've got power. We have the controller all has power. Now we're going to use the wireless telemetry to connect to the drone. So we're gonna go to serial port, TTY USB 0, 57600, and then hit connect. Boom. Connected here. It's gonna start pulling flight data in a second here. You'll see, that's letting you know it's connected right there. And then give it a second, and we should start getting data. Boom, there it is. Showing battery. We don't have a GPS fix or anything. Now we're gonna hit initial setup. Click on mandatory setup. And then frame type, you're gonna select X style. Compass, you're gonna do live calibration. Click on that and follow the directions there, which will ask you to like spin your device in all these different directions for a minute. Then you're gonna go to Excel calibration. And then you're going to have to move this around on its axis. So you're going to make sure you want to be somewhere where you can spin the drone around. So first thing we're going to do is calibrate the compass. We hit live calibration here. And we want to move it around all axes. So once we hit OK there, and it's starting to time for us, we're going to give it a spin forward, give it a spin backward, give it a spin sideways. Give it a spin the other sideways. Give it a spin around the base like this. And just kind of keep doing that until the 60 seconds are up. Doing that. Boom. Sets up the new offsets. Click OK on there. Next thing you want to do is your Excel calibration. Calibrate there. Press vehicle level. Hit your space bar. Place vehicle on its left side. Boom. Right side. Boom. Nose down. Boom. Nose up. Upside down. And that's it. Now we're gonna move on to the next calibration. Radio calibrations at this point. Flip your radio on. Check and see that your things are moving when you move your stick or your pitch and stuff. So we'll hit calibrate. Make sure all the props are off. Shit might go crazy, so it's telling you on this message right here. Boom. Click OK, then move all sticks to their extreme positions. This includes all the switches. So OK on there. You go here, here. Calibration there. Boom. Calibrate it. Now I go to your flight modes. So flight mode one, where we're at here, we'll stabilize. Flip that switch so we know where we're at. Okay, flight mode two. I'm sorry, I'm gonna put flight mode one as loiter because I think that's easier to use. We'll do flight mode 2 as stabilize. Flight mode 3, return to land. Set all these on loiter, except for the very last one, which on mine means I got these two switches here all the way down, and that at that point is going to put it into auto mode. Got the thing calibrated. I'm doing my initial arm test. So I've got my little button hooked up here. I can disarm it there. And then put this thing in ready mode. And even though I don't have a full GPS fix, if I take it out of loiter and put it into stabilize mode, it'll let me arm the motors. And so I can see them all working and coordinating together. So hold the sticks in like this. Boom, it's showing armed. And it's attempting to take off now, but there's no propellers on it. And I'm hearing sounds change when I hit the stick. So far it seems like we're doing pretty good. Go ahead and bring it down and then hold it out this way to disarm. So arming is down, both sticks all the way down and all the way in. Disarming is both sticks all the way down and all the way out. So once you got that and your thing's calibrated, next thing we're gonna do is actually take this on a test flight once I get a new motor. So thanks for tubing in. Hope you've been liking the series on this S500 drone. I've sure had fun making it. Like, subscribe, share, tell your friends, you know, all that fun piratical stuff. So have an awesome day. Get out there and fly and keep going.